I'm Rick Love for TV at the 25th Annual Sonoma International Film Festival. And I'm here with writer-director Phil Connell and lead actor Thomas Duplessie, who brought the feature film Jump Darling to the festival. A rookie drag queen reeling from a breakup escapes to the country where he finds his grandmother in steep decline, yet desperate to avoid the local nursing home. So the big get with this movie is the grandmother, played by Cloris Leachman. Amazing actress, known to all of our viewers. How do you go about securing it for your film?
Particular film, it was going to be this tiny, kind of scrappy, intimate family drama, Canadian first feature film, my first feature film, and we always sort of had this idea that we had a chance at a star for this particular role because it was a film-carrying role for an actor over the age of, you know, 85. In Cloris's case, she was 93, and Cloris was known to be indie-friendly and, you know, consistently working still. So we just gave it a shot, and you know, the script, I guess, resonated with her and her team, and she agreed to do it. So, you know, that was kind of it. It was a bit of strategy and a bit of luck, you know.
And was the opening nude scene, was that on the first day of shooting, or was that later on in the shoot?
That was later on. Okay. So yeah, the first scene we shot with her was when they met for the first time on camera, but as stars, both as actors and as characters, they met for the first time in a take, Thomas and Cloris. Mm-hmm. Pretty cool, but the nude scene, I think 2 or 3 days in.
And Thomas, what was it like acting across from somebody like Cloris Leachman?
I mean, dream come true. It sounds a bit cliche, but I mean, when you're an actor, it's everything that you hope for, kind of to act opposite, you know, somebody with, you know, such a history in the biz. I mean, she was everything Cloris is known for and more. She was rude, she was spontaneous, she was hilarious, sassy, and really actually quite vulnerable. But she was a blast to work with. Yeah, it was a joy every mm-hmm. day.
Yeah, it's very exciting to see her when I, because I call up these trailers and I'm not used to seeing a star of Cloris Leachman up there.
It's wild.
Phil, from your IMDb page, it looks like this is your first feature. What was it like making a short?
It was a long journey between when I made transition that I mean, really, you know, once we were there.
And
no experience ever actually performing in drag, but you know, I've been down at Church Street in Toronto for the last, you know, 13 years out at drag bars. Like, I have very close friends who do drag, so I'm very well acquainted with the drag world. I love it, but no, this is the first time I've ever kind of, you know, slapped on a wig and heels and went for it.
And Phil, what made you decide to have the drag scene as the backdrop for your story?
Yeah, well, I was telling a story about, you know, in many, it's about a lot of things, but Russell's story in the film is about choosing life as an artist, and specifically choosing life as a queer artist, and drag is kind of like the penultimate form of queer art. You know, it's a merger of all the identity issues and gender issues that come along with the queer experience merged into an art form that confronts that. And so that was what was appealing to me in terms of telling a story about choosing life as an artist, but you know, the courage of the specific art form of drag.
Mm-hmm. 90% fresh Rotten Tomatoes rating. Does that have any impact? Is that a big help? Is it do anything for you when you're promoting your film?
Good question. I think so. I mean, I don't know that it helps. I think when people have heard of the film, it's good to have a good rating, you know? When people are like, am I gonna watch this? You know, those reviews show up on the platforms, the, you know, the little tomato meter thing is, you know, on the Apple, you know, if you're VODing it or you're buying it from wherever, that's often there. So people will be like, people liked it. Okay, good, I'll try it. I liked the trailer, but now that I know that. So I would say it does help, you know? It certainly keeps people from running away once they've found it.
Thomas, you're going to see at my favorite venue of all the venues in the film festival, the Sebastiani Theater.
Yeah.
Beautiful 100 plus year old theater. Have you Amazing. Seen the film up on a big screen yet?
Yes, a couple of times, which has always been really exciting. The first time was actually at a drive-in in Toronto because of COVID and whatnot. But that was the first time we had seen it with an audience, but everybody was in a car, so you couldn't really feel it.
Gauge the interaction.
Yeah, but the first time that we saw it kind of in a full theater with you know, on the big screen was at Frameline.
At the Castro.
Summer at the Castro.
Well, that theater is bigger than our theater, but our theater is beautiful.
It looks beautiful. Yeah.
It looks amazing. We're excited.
Writer-director Phil Connell and lead actor Thomas Duplessie, thanks very much for being here today. Their film is Jump, Darling, playing at the Sebastiani Theater tomorrow. I'm Rick Love for Sonoma TV at the 25th Annual Sonoma International Film Festival.